Hi and welcome. Today I'm going to be chatting to Elaine. Elaine is a registered nurse and also a certified nurse immunizer. She is passionate about what she does and she's going to share some insights on whether we should vaccinate whilst we are pregnant, whether young children should be vaccinated, and if those with allergies can also get immunizations, and her advice around those who think that vaccines are not safe for their little ones and what you should do. Welcome, Elaine. Hi, Elaine. Thank you for joining me today, and thanks for having this interview. So what I'll do is I'll just ask you a couple of questions, and if you could answer those for me, that would be amazing. Can you tell me, first of all, about your journey into motherhood? Was it easy or was it difficult, or how did that go for you?
So I think with my first child, it was we had problems actually falling pregnant. So we tried for a bit, and but eventually I went to doctors, and all our questions answered, and eventually, so what turned out to be a challenge was actually both of us being too stressed. So So the doctor said, just go take a weekend away, and boom, my first one came. So yeah, since then I've had a couple more. So I'm a mom to a 5-year-old, a 2-year-old, and now a 2-month-old as well. So,
wow.
A brand new one, so
congratulations. So
thank you. It's sleepless nights, but also worth it. So so for me, the easy part I think every child is different, but if I were to say one thing that's similar for all three of them is how much I actually love them and not do anything for them. So that's the easy part for me. And the challenging part I think is what a lot of moms will experience as well, what they call mom guilt, where I actually need to just leave everything and just look after myself as well. So that's a part I'm still struggling with at the moment. But apart from that, it's been such a wonderful journey with the three kids.
Great. Yeah, I think we all get the mum guilt, whether we work from home or whether we don't work or we stay at home with the kids. I think all get it no matter what. There's no easy balance. So you're a certified immunization nurse, and why are you passionate about that?
So I also, apart from being a nurse immunizer, I also work in oncology, which is where I look after cancer patients. So that's where I see some of the most sick people that in our community. They come in, they have chemotherapy, they have radiotherapy. And I even see children as young as 18 months all coming in for treatment. Some of them are not, they're not up to date with the vaccines because they're too unwell, they're immunocompromised. So I think for me, it's a way of trying to advocate so that they get protected because they can't be vaccinated. But we, as the well people, we can actually get the vaccines and try not to give them any of this potentially fatal diseases that would make them even sicker, and potentially they could die from it. So that's why I'm advocating for this, and hopefully people get the vaccines up to date.
So going to talking about when you're pregnant, should pregnant mums be immunized?
Yes, definitely. We say women should be vaccinated when they're pregnant, and this provides protection for them and for their babies as well, especially against two serious infections. The first one is pertussis, or we know it better as whooping cough. So because babies can actually die from whooping cough because when they're newborn, they're too young to get the vaccines. So again, they rely on mom, dad, brother, sisters, people who visit, all to protect themselves. So they don't come into contact with people who might bring this deadly disease to them. It's free in Australia, so the government gives it to pregnant women, and we recommend it between 28 to 32 weeks of gestation. And and there's been, we don't see like side effects. It's very rare to get side effects, and it's completely safe for mom and for baby. And the second one is influenza, or people call it the flu. If a mom gets influenza during pregnancy, it might actually cause premature delivery or even infant death as well. So it's, and it gets more severe with pregnant women. Women can actually, pregnancies can actually be hospitalized from it as well. And babies under 6 months, because they can't get the vaccine, they're at high risk of being hospitalized as well. And we'll try to prevent that from happening if mom gets the vaccine. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah, definitely. In New Zealand as well, the vaccine is for whooping cough is free when you're pregnant as well. And same with influenza. So going on from that, vaccines, why are vaccines so important? I think you've already touched on it with the people who you see who are immunocompromised, but why are they so important, especially when the diseases themselves aren't all that common? So if you could, answer that.
We don't see these diseases often anymore because of the high percentage of people getting vaccines, and it's still needed to protect us because just because it's rare doesn't mean that, you know, it won't come back. Or people who are too unwell, they can't get the vaccine, doesn't mean that they won't get infected by it. So the first thing is, we need to make sure people who can't be vaccinated are still protected. So such as young babies, people with certain illnesses. So this is what we call the herd immunity. So these people who are too unwell, they won't be able to get any of these infections from us who have been vaccinated. Yeah, and then we also need to make sure, as I said before, we make sure that the diseases don't return as well. Because I think we've had some studies, like back in 1974, Japan actually had a high vaccination rate. So diphtheria was at a very low rate. And then there were rumors saying that vaccines were unsafe, or, you know, because there's so few cases now, we don't need the vaccines anymore. And then I think, was it 1980 or 1979? Yeah, that's when diphtheria came back in a high rate again. So when they reintroduced the vaccine, and it went back down again. So that was probably in the 1980s that it happened. So there's proof that vaccines do actually work. And in Australia, in New Zealand, there's some diseases that are already quite rare, but it doesn't mean that it's not happening in other countries. So we need to prevent that from being reintroduced in our countries again and causing a massive outbreak. So. Yeah, so definitely vaccines are still very important, even though it's rarely seen, the diseases. Yeah,
definitely. Any countries that don't have the such as like measles or anything, you know, if it's a lower rate in New Zealand, it's only a plane ride away. So
It's happening in Melbourne now as well. We've seen measles happening from travellers overseas.
We've got a huge outbreak of measles at the moment in Auckland, which isn't fantastic. I've got a lot of pregnant friends and with babies under 6 months old. Yeah. We used to not vaccinate for measles until, I think it was 18 months old, but now they've had to bring that even lower,
12 months.
Which is a shame. So how do immunizations and natural immunity work together, or do they work in opposition?
So I think immunity from vaccinations and natural immunity, they probably do the same thing, but vaccinations is better in the sense that it causes the immunity without actually causing the disease. So that's the safest way of developing the immunity. So, catching the disease is no way safe, you know, to develop the immunity, because first of all, you may not survive it. That's my first point. So vaccines can make the disease less severe as well, even if the immunity wears off, there is that booster. So that way it keeps your body, prevents your body from catching that disease. Or even if you do catch it, it's a very mild form. You don't get the full-blown disease that, again, be potentially fatal. And also, vaccinations provides community immunity, or herd immunity, as we call it. Yeah. And I think with vaccines, because there's combinations, it protects you against multiple infections or multiple diseases and virus and bacteria. And it's, yeah, as I was saying, it's a lot safer than actually catching the actual disease and getting natural immunity to kick in, yeah.
And so if I had the influenza vaccine, can that then cause me to get the flu?
So influenza vaccine itself doesn't cause the flu. It's because the vaccine itself is inactivated, so it's not a live virus, so you can't actually get the actual influenza. So there's a lot of factors. Like, first of all, when you get the flu vaccine, this is what I tell my patients, where were you when you were waiting for your flu vaccine? You're in a doctor's office, the waiting room, people that were sick, you probably caught it from them as well. Or else, it depends on what strain you were vaccinated against and how well that strain matches the current strain that's going around that you come into contact with. Also, if you do get any mild flu-like symptoms, that's just the body's way of telling you that the vaccine's working and you're developing the immunity against the flu vaccine. And then, yeah, I was saying that, you know, not the flu vaccine is not 100% effective in preventing the influenza because of different strains that's happening. It mutates every year. So it's always important that you keep on top of the vaccines, get vaccinated every year so that you're having the most recent one.
Yeah, definitely. And can young children have vaccines, and especially children even with allergies, can they have vaccines as well?
Absolutely. So like with any parent who has any concerns, we always say speak to the GP to get get advice. But we rarely see allergies from vaccines itself. If anything, it's mostly latex allergy because of the vaccine equipment. It's not the vaccine itself. So yeah, if you've got asthma, you've got eczema, hay fever, food allergies, most of these children can still be safely vaccinated. And I actually personally know one of my lecturers, her son had an anaphylactic reaction to one of the vaccines. He went to a hospital to get it done, and he is actually up to date with his vaccines and all. Further issues with that. So definitely, if you have any concerns, speak to your GP and try to get all the vaccines up to date if possible.
Yeah. I used to have an egg white allergy, and I know a long time ago when I was getting vaccines as a child, I think the vaccines used to possibly be something, it was something stored or something in egg white, but now they're not. So they always would make me stay an extra amount of time just to make sure that I didn't
even with children who have, or children or any adults who get vaccines, we usually say stay for the first 15 minutes just to make sure you're fine before you go, because if there's any reaction, it usually happens in the first 15 minutes. And in my 10 years as a nurse, I've never seen a reaction before. So that's how rare it is, yeah.
So is it safe for children or adults to have more than one vaccine at a time? And also, why are the vaccine schedules spaced out the way that they are, for example?
So there's been a lot of research that now shown that giving children several vaccines at the same time is absolutely safe. They haven't had any reactions to it. So vaccines, like, there are some which are combination, so that's like a few in one injection, or there's some that come in separate injections, and so both forms have shown to be very safe and induce the same amount of immune response and as if they were to have it separately as well. And the risk with giving it separately and spaced out is that it will delay the exposure of the antigens to the young children, and they may potentially get ill because they're not up to date with their vaccines. Right. And with the immunization schedule, it's basically giving the vaccines at the age where it's safe for them. And think of the child's body as like a brain where you study something and you have that memory of it. So that's like your body having the memory of being exposed to the antigen. But because you're young, sometimes your immune response is not as good as an older person. So you need that boost, like a boost in the memory. So that's where you get the boosters, and it's spaced out so that it gives your body time to actually build up the immunity, and then you just boost it so that it's basically building up that memory so that if you do get exposed to it in the future, you know, you have the immune response to it.
Right.
And in some vaccines, you still need boosters throughout the life because, it can wear off. Whereas some, like the measles, mumps, and rubella, usually it's lifelong immunity. But then again, it varies from individual to individual. So it's always good to be in touch with the GP and make sure you're up to date and you're protected.
Right. Great. And finally, what's your advice or your reaction to people who think that vaccines are dangerous or harmful or going to hurt their child in some way or cause some long-term problem?
So I can understand some people probably have that idea because they personally had trauma through vaccines, or some because they've been told by certain sources that, you know, it's unsafe, and, you know, giving them like scare tactics and they're like, oh, no, I don't really want my child to be exposed to all this. It's dangerous, it's poisonous. So what I usually say is that I understand that you may have gone through some difficulties or some trauma with the vaccines. But you can't deny that in these many years, vaccines have definitely saved a lot of lives. And on the other hand, I can't force you or yourself or your child to be vaccinated. So all I can say is make sure you make informed decisions. Make sure the sources that you get this information from is credible. And that way, you know, you can make a choice whether or not you want your child to be protected against this potentially fatal diseases. But in myself personally, I'll advocate, you know, definitely it's there and it's been proven to be safe. So, you know, please, yeah, vaccinate your child, vaccinate yourself, protect your child, protect the people around you who cannot actually get this vaccine.
Thank you so much, Elaine, for chatting with us today and giving us so much insightful information about vaccines. And I hope that everyone has gained a little bit of knowledge about vaccines and what the concept of herd immunity and helping actually protect those who potentially can't be immunized, especially in its. And also, you know, not getting the disease itself, which is always ideal.
Absolutely.
But thank you so much for chatting, and we will see you later.